Okay, good afternoon all. Thank you for attending this short demo on how to record a video lecture using OBS, as we all need this in our future conduction of syllabus. So I'll just share my screen. I hope it is visible. Okay. So let's start with OBS. What is OBS? So I'll just Google it. I'll search OBS. OBS is Open Broadcaster Software. It is used to record our screen, as well as we can using this software we can live stream our videos and audio sessions, like a broadcast and video lectures on YouTube as well as Facebook. Any streaming platform, it is compatible with any streaming platform. So while going to obsproject.com, we'll see this home screen. Okay, so for as I am using Windows, I'll just download it. So it will take time, but I already had downloaded this, and after clicking downloading, it will just look like this, OBS Studio. I hope my screen is visible to everybody. So by double clicking it, it will open, and just installation is as simple as any other software on Windows. By just double clicking it, the setup exe file will go to next, and finish option will be there. So after installation, it will create a shortcut on our desktop, and it's look like just the logo, this wheel types logo. It will show on desktop, and we can run it as an administrator, or we can just execute. If you are an admin user, then you can just launch it. But if you are not admin user and you are logging from some different other user, you need to give its access or privileges to get your graphics card, so that it will record your video. So in some cases, what happens, there might be two graphics card, one is Intel and one is Nvidia. In that case, it will not capture your screen. So the troubleshooting part is another part that I will explain later, or if anybody is facing problem, then I will help them to sort that problem. So it only occurs when there will be a two graphics card. But in most of the cases, there is no two graphics card. There is a single graphics from Intel. So it will easily capture the screen. So once you launch the configure the your OBS, you will see the screen like this. And here you can see the auto configuration wizard here. So once you download and install, it will ask your uses. If you are using for streaming, then configure your settings as per the optimized streaming. If you are using for recording, then configure it as per the recording. So as simple as just click next, and it will capture the screen. So it is my current resolution of the screen, and it is the FPS ratio. 60 FPS videos are quite bigger than 30 FPS. So I had made already a settings for that. So to reduce the video size, I'll show you at the setting part. To here in the output, you can see audio bitrate and stream streaming ratio. So I kept it as a same as streaming. As per my bandwidth, it will optimize my video compatible ratio so that video size is not getting larger. If you want the high quality videos, then you can choose the lossless quality. That will be a quite huge file. It means for 10 to 20 minutes, it will generate 1.5 GB file. And if we go for same as stream, for 30 minutes, it will generate almost 300 MB. File, and it will be a quite good to understand. So I'll recommend this setting, and for FPS ratio, I'll keep it as a 30 only. So if you increase the FPS value, the video size also increases. So apart from this, I have nothing changed the settings. These two are the major changes which I have done. And then here you can see the sources. So firstly, I want to capture my entire screen. So because I am continuously switching from one application to another application, means like browser to PPTs and PPTs to video. So that's why I want to capture my display. So here at the source, you have to add display capture. And by default, I am capturing it. So you will see like this. Okay. So window under window under window, this is the what we say, it is the screen resolutions ratios as per compatible with the different devices, like your video can be visible on mobile also, ads and that small iPods also. That's why this is the settings. Another part is we want to capture our audio input. So by default, we have to add the audio. Here you can see, as I am using headset, and this is my system, default system microphone, but I am using headphone, and it is quite good, better than my system microphone. So I'll choose this as a my input device, and for output also I'll choose my earphone. So after that, if you want to display your face on screen, so just add the video here, video capture device. It will automatically on your camera, laptop camera. So for if you want to show your video, so then you have to add this video capture device, and it will show you the screen, and you just minimize by using the mouse drag, and you can put it anywhere from the screen as per your suitable position. So once this setup is done, then I can start my recording. Here you can see start recording. Once you click on start recording, it will capture entire screen of your desktop screen. Then I'm here clicking start recording, then it is started. So now I can go with the presentation or anything that I want to show with the students, and I can explain just like syllabus or anything what I am doing is recording now. That is, okay, so is everybody is able to see my YouTube?
Yes, sir.
So okay, then after that we'll just once you finish the recording, we'll just stop the recording, and it will take a little bit time to save your recordings, and you can go to the file menu, and here you can see the show recordings. So here is your file created. So I'll just play it and you will understand. So in between, if you take a gap, then you can create multiple files as. After saving this, you will get the file, and if it takes time, multiple files you will create. Suppose you are going to explain some what we'll say installation video, and installation video, it will take time. Suppose it is going to take 20 to 30 minutes time, then you can stop the recording, and once it gets completed, then you can start the recording. At that time, it will create a multiple files like this, as I have. So for that, I am using inbuilt software for Windows. That is nothing but the simple merge and trim option. Is a simple video trim and merge. This is the software, inbuilt software. It comes with the Windows 10. If you don't have it, you can just download it from Microsoft Studio also. It is easily available, and it is free with the Windows 10. So after installing this, you will see the screen like this. And in this video, you can add multiple videos, and after adding multiple videos, you can trim. I'll just show you how I'm going to do that video editing part. It will take at least half an hour, but I'm not going to process that video, so it will just explain in 2 minutes. So after adding multiple videos from here, add button 1, 2, 3, 4 in sequence, we can edit it one by one. It is a trimmer. For starting sections, you can just eliminate that setting part from your video, and after the trimming, you can merge, and at that time merge here, you can change your format. MP4 format you can take, and MP4 or anything, AVI are compatible, any format you would like to choose, you just take it, and after that you just save the video in fast or precise, any mode. It will ask you a location and give it the file name, and after this you can see my today's video. Where it is saved? I think it's in document. Okay, so after merging all these files, I'll get one file. This is almost 380 MB for 23 minutes, 386 MB for 23 minutes, and it is, you can convert this video using any video converter, or by at the time of saving from this software, you can change the file format. So I'll just open my video. So this part I can trim. So this is the installation of MySQL. So likewise, I have created the video for installation, and likewise we can create the practical videos also. And it is, as it is open source, so it will be it is giving a full, what I say, full features are open to us to explore. With this software, you can also live stream with the YouTube. That part we'll see next time, because for the purpose as how to record the video lectures, this part I think is sufficient. Thank you so much.